I'm not saying it's easy, to be honest, it's not. Most days, you see me crying. You see, like, I worked 100 days as a software developer. After 50 days, I cry. I literally cry, like, almost every time. Because the thing is, it can be hard. Yeah, it's quite challenging. Yeah, but the good thing is, it gives you the opportunity to actually challenge yourself. Hi, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Chidinma Otutu and I am a software developer. First of all, I want to thank you guys for subscribing to my YouTube channel. I started this channel around April. Like, I started posting on this channel around April, and so far I've gotten over 500 subscribers. To be very honest, it's quite encouraging, and I want to use this time to say a very big thank you to you all. And if you're new, please do not forget to hit the subscribe button and give a thumbs up if you enjoy the video. The compliment of the season, and I'm also wishing you a very wonderful new year. I know you're looking forward to 2021. I am also looking forward to 2021 and what it has in store for all of us. So right into the video. This video is just about me telling you how I became a software developer and my coding journey so far. Now, how did the interest in software development start? I didn't really have the interest in the first place. So let's take it back to probably when I was in secondary school. During long vacations, most long vacations, my dad would send my elder brothers and I to computer school, just so that we don't idle at home. So he will register us into this computer school where they will just teach you the basics of computer, like typing and CorelDRAW, how to use Microsoft Word, Excel sheet and all. But that wasn't even, there was no coding in it then. But when I got into the university, I actually applied for medicine and surgery, but I got electrical engineering. And I know, right? Very weird. That would be a story for another day. But then when I was schooling in engineering, I think our second year, we had this course, Introduction to C# or C++. I can't remember fully. But then that was my first time coming in contact with coding. And then in my second year in school, I had a laptop, but I didn't really know how to code. So the course just taught us the very basics of programming, like C#, if I remember correctly. Yeah, but then after the course, the interest still wasn't there. I graduated from the university. So after I graduated from the university, I went straight to do my NYSC. NYSC in Nigeria is National Youth Service Corps, where you have to, it's compulsory, you serve your country for 1 year. So during my NYSC was when my friend, she sent me a message that she saw an opening where an NGO, a charity organization in Abuja, wants to sponsor 4 ladies who are interested in learning programming. But because my friends, they've already started coding, I was like, okay, why not I try this since I'm not doing so much right now? So I applied for the scholarship, and lucky me, I was among the ladies they chose to learn. So when the program, it lasted for 4 months, yeah, and they taught us HTML, CSS, and a little bit of PHP. During the program, that was when I learned how to build static websites, you know, just no functionality, just HTML and CSS. So what our tutors then would do is they would give us like websites to go and replicate. So that was actually when the interest kicked in. You know, the fact that you could build something and then you see it. So I was like, okay, I really want to pursue this. I want to continue and probably along the way turn it into a career or something. So that was how the program lasted for 4 months. And at the end of the program, I applied to a company in Lagos called Andela. And why I actually applied was because my friends, they had already gotten job there and they told me how amazing the company was. So I was like, okay, why don't I try my luck? I mean, there is no harm and the program is already coming to an end. So I need to continue if I want to forge ahead. So I applied for the first time. I failed. I didn't pass the interview stage. I was like, okay, let me try again. And then I tried again and I was accepted. So but for you to be able to get accepted into Andela, you have to go through a phase they call the bootcamp phase. So during the bootcamp phase was when I built like partially a real life project. But like, so what the project, it gave me the opportunity to learn both front end and back end. Yeah, not like I became a pro, honestly, but like it gave me the opportunity to use Node.js, Express.js for the back end, then database, and then for the front end, I had to learn JavaScript and master my HTML and CSS properly. So when, after the bootcamp, to be honest, my friends are great. So they actually helped me to go through the bootcamp phase. Like, you know, starting programming or coding, it's not easy. It's interesting, yeah, but it has a lot of challenges, especially when you don't have people who are probably guiding you or mentoring you. It could become like a struggle and at some point you would want to give up. But the good thing was I had good support system. So my friends, whenever I had a blocker, I always reach out to them, and in one way or the other, they helped me figure it out, or explain to me. Another thing was I also took advantage of YouTube, I took advantage of Udemy. So most times when I don't understand things, I go online and Google it or watch a YouTube video that explains how it should be done. Yeah, so after the bootcamp program, when I got into Andela, they shared us into a team of seven. I was the only girl in my particular team, but in the cohort, so I think we're 21 and we're like two ladies. Yeah, so when they shared us into teams, they gave us a project to work on. The project was what now gave me a better understanding of this programming. You have to write tests and you have to make use of Mocha, Jest, and all, a lot of technologies. One thing about programming is you have to keep learning, and every day there must be something new for you to learn. But then the thing is, my journey in Andela didn't last so long. Yeah, it didn't last so long, and I think it was for 3 months. I started August and I had to leave October. The reason and everything will be a story for another day. But then after Andela, I got the opportunity to work with other amazing companies in Lagos, Nigeria. I worked with Dev Center. I worked with a company called Schoolable. Yeah, so like the thing about programming is, or coding, is consistency. Yeah, for you to be able to grow as a software developer, you have to be very consistent. I'm not saying it's easy, to be honest, it's not. Most days, you see me crying. You see, like days I've worked 100 days as a software developer, out of 50 days, I cry. I literally cry like almost every time, because the thing is, it can be hard. Yeah, it's quite challenging. Yeah, but the good thing is it gives you the opportunity to actually challenge yourself, because you have to constantly learn new things. You can't hold back on what you've just learned now. If not, the world will move past by, you get. So you have to constantly upgrade yourself, you have to constantly learn. And then the good thing about it too is coding or programming gives you the opportunity to meet amazing smart people. And then if you can also learn to join communities and make friends. Because to be very honest with you, how I was able to speed up, I'm still a work in progress, I'm still learning, but how I was able to speed up, to be able to apply to companies and work on projects and deliver, was because I had people, you get, I had people I reached out to, and I also like watched YouTube videos a lot. I also took courses on Udemy. Like I said, consistency is not going to be easy. You get, it's not going to be easy, but you just have to keep pushing through. You have to like have goals for yourself. So, and another thing I would advise is, please do not compare yourself to someone else, because it can be depressing. when you say, oh, this is what this person is doing, this is where this person is, and look at me, what you're supposed to do is just compare yourself to what you were yesterday, what you were last month. I started programming fully ending of 2018. So when I want to compare myself, I check it. Okay, this is where I am today compared to 2019. Where was I? Am I still the same person? But if you try to compare yourself with someone else, some people learn slowly, some people learn faster. Some people have a better support system, some people do not. Some people have money to purchase courses that are expensive that will teach you more, some people don't. So for you to, if you want to do any comparison, please make sure it's with yourself. Check, okay, this is what I've been able to do here. Well, how do I push on? How do I get better? How do I forge ahead? Okay. And then another thing about programming as well, or for me, my journey is that I am ready to take feedback. In programming, this journey, you have to know how to accept feedback. Some people are very mean when it comes to giving feedback, while some people are kind. But the good thing is, if you can learn to take the feedback no matter how it comes, it will help you as a software developer. That was how I was able to grow. When I was working in school level, I had a very great CTO/manager. He constantly gave me feedback. Another thing I do is I also try to seek feedback. If I'm working in a team, probably after a project, I'll be like, okay, what do you think I can do better? How do you think I can improve? So if you can constantly seek for people to give you feedback, and then also try to take that feedback, not just listening to the feedback, try to work on whatever feedback you've gotten from someone, it will make you grow faster. You know, like then when I was in Mandela, when we raise a pull request, there's something we call pull request, if you're a programmer, where the work you've done on your laptop, you push it online and then other people can see what you've done. Then, if they leave a comment on my PR, it was always a big deal for me. With time, I got better. I got used to it. That's like taking feedback where someone would tell you, you know, like when you do something in your eyes, it's very perfect. But then when someone else looks at it, the person thinks, oh, this is where I see you can improve. If you can learn to share your work with people, telling them, oh, what do you think? Do you think I can do this better? Because when another eye sees it, the mistake you think is not there, someone else can say. And the good thing about software development is you can actually move faster compared to, like, I don't know about other career paths, but software development, the career path is a bit straightforward. What I mean by straightforward is you can give yourself a target goal. In the next 3-4 months, I want to achieve this, I want to achieve that. And with that, the more experience and knowledge you have, the higher your pay. You get? So that's one thing about software development. So you can build your pace and say, okay, I want to learn this, I want to do this. Okay? So consistency, discipline. When the going gets tough, hold your head. Okay, don't, like, you know, maybe you want to learn, maybe for people that want to start programming, you start today, the next time you're going to code again is in the next 2-3 months. When you go back after 2-3 months, you are going to start afresh. So if it's something like maybe this thing they do 100 days of coding where every day you give maybe 30 minutes or 40 minutes or 1 hour or 2 hours, maybe in a week, 5 times, like Monday to Friday, you set out like 1 hour or 2 hours to work on it. To be very honest, in the next 6 months, you would see the difference. Definitely. You would definitely see the difference. Try to join the community. I think that is it. So software development for me has been amazing. It's been really good. It challenges me as a person. It has made me grow, not just career-wise, but as a person on my own. That's taught me discipline. That's taught me that whatever life throws at you, you can always try to handle it. At first, it might seem very difficult, but with time, it gets better. So yes, that is my journey so far as a software developer. I'm currently working as a back-end engineer in a company called Choco in Germany, Berlin. Yeah, and fun fact, I'm the only female backend engineer currently in Choco. But then I have amazing people, I have amazing colleagues, so it's not so noticeable, and I'm having fun. Yeah, I'm having fun. So if you have any question regarding software, programming, coding, you can just leave your questions in the comment section. If I don't have answers to it, we can always research together and find a solution or whatever problem you're having. And I hope you enjoyed this video. Please do not forget to give me a thumbs up if you like it and subscribe.